Hey, any fish? It's the 2nd of February, 2018, and the little ground dweller didn't come out of his hole today. So that means more winter, right? But what I wanted to point out here is just this. This is becoming, like, really weird because, you know, CBS is a national article, you know? And they sit here and say that a Christian holiday, see, February 2nd is Candlemas. A Christian holiday. What is a Christian? A Christian is a follower of Jesus Christ, if I'm not mistaken. Well, I don't know one single follower of Jesus Christ, a true follower that is, that celebrates Candlemas. Okay? Pre-Christian roots? Yeah. Then it's not Christian at all. It's pre-Christian. It's pagan. Marks Mary's ritual purification. How did they get pre-Christian roots to form into something marking Mary's ritual purification? This is just heresy, really. But, you know, don't tell that to the Catholics, because I'll tell you what, they still have their feast of presentation to the Lord. Candlemas Day. Oops, that's the wrong one right here. Look at this. I mean, come on. Worshipping the Virgin, changing pagan holidays and solstice worship days and whatnot into Christian holidays. In pre-Christian times, it was the Festival of Light. The Celts called it Imbolc. The midpoint between winter and spring. See, another one of their little mid-season sun worship rituals. And, you know, the Catholics just sucked it right in as they co-opted the whole true Christian movement. It just makes me sick that people still buy into this stuff. And I know a lot of people are starting not to, but nonetheless, this day, really, if we go back to its pagan roots, you know what it really was? Here, let me show you. That's what it was right there. Let me shut this thing down here. Stupid thing. That's what it was right here. See him ripping the heart out of this guy? Because that's what Candlemas is. That's a blood sacrifice satanic holiday. Along with their satanic revels, their sexual orgies, and all their just wonderful behavior. I mean, this is what it's originated from. It has nothing to do with Christ. Nothing, nada, not at all, not a thing. Nothing. But you better believe CBS is going to tell you it does. And then the stinking Vatican just makes it real for the world. Oh, see? Yeah, it's a real holiday. I mean, this is just crazy, you guys. Crazy. Ridiculous. But you know, there it is. You wouldn't believe what this stuff all connects to. I mean, it's just, you know, I get so much, it's like I don't even know how to share it with people. But all this Catholic pagan garbage here, this is all tied right in with the synagogue of Satan. The Jews who say they're Jews, but they're not. They tie together. They're hand in hand. And look at this article just from today. Oh, yesterday. Okay, the first. But, battleground for Mount Zion. The Vatican is so intertwined in Israel, it's sickening. And you have guys like this deceiver, fake Jew, hired by the government of Israel to do the Ark report. Like, this guy, he's just deceiving people left and right. And the reason there's a battle here, all this stuff between the Palestinians and stuff, stems right out of the Vatican. They were just tied right in from the beginning of the formation of the State of Israel. In fact, Mount Zion, a site of great importance to the Jewish people, of course, is almost entirely owned by the Vatican. And you should see some of the atrocities they do. I mean, it's all right in front of our face, and it's all coming to light. So while everybody, you know, giggles and laughs at ground dweller Phil, they're essentially feeding the beast. in just an inadvertent way, because they aren't walking in the spirit of Jesus Christ. This is these deceivers, these people who pin the Christian name on the Catholic Church, are just deceivers and blind, and it's all coming to light, and everyone will know the truth. It's just a matter of time. You need to know Jesus Christ. Okay? So, yeah, that was interesting. Y'all have a great day, okay? Peace and grace to you. Any fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,